Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to the participants of various time zones. It is immense pleasure to start this session and in the title of Introduction to VMware Aria Automation. And almost we are having 12 participants. Very happy to see all of them. This product is going to, what is the capabilities and how the product will be? That is what we are going to discuss in this session. Before that, I would like to start by means of my self-introduction. This is Kannan Manoharan, and I'm a corporate trainer in Koenig Solutions Private Limited, and I'm a VMware certified instructor and a Microsoft certified trainer too. And I'm a certified professional for data center virtualization, network virtualization, and application modernization, and cloud management and automation. That is the course. That is a certification for our Aria Automation and the desktop and mobility. And I'm having around 16 years of commendable experience on teaching. Both I have started my career from the institution as an assistant professor, and now I'm as a trainer for VMware products. VMware, you know very well about it. So we are mainly focuses on the virtualization content. So we are having the how we can able to provide the virtualization by means of giving the suites, vSphere suites, and the ESXi hypervisors. And on that, based on the hypervisor, you can able to create a software-defined data center. And over the software-defined data center, to manage as an administrator, you have to be with the some other products. So we are having the products for all the kind of natures. Like to get the network virtualization, we are having NSX. And to get the application modernization, we are having Tanzu. And to get the automation, cloud automation and management by means of our product called Aria. Aria is formerly called as VRLIS. So they have renamed and providing the product in the name of Aria. So we are having inside that Aria portfolio, we are having a lot of products, Aria Automation, Aria Operations, and Aria Operations for Network Logs. So these are the different products we are having. And this webinar is going to provide an overview and architecture designs we are having with our Aria Automation. Okay. And so that can be covered with the VMware course, VMware Aria Automation Install Config Manage. Okay. In that itself, we are going to take some of the contents to give you the overview and architecture. So before getting into it, so this Aria Automation, you have to understand what is the Aria Automation and what are the benefits you can be able to get and what are the components we are inside our Aria Automation. That is what we are going to discuss from this webinar. So let me get into the, without wasting any time, let me get into the topic, VMware Aria Automation. So what is the importance of the webinar is to provide the introduction about the product. It is a cloud management platform with some numerous components. The cloud management platform, we are going to provide software as a service from VMware Cloud Services Organization. And to implement our Aria Automation successfully, you have to be with some idea on the component and architecture first. You have to understand what are the components are there and how the components are going to use for your deployment. That is what we are going to discuss in this course. Okay. So first, we will get the introduction to Aria Automation. VMware Aria Automation is a platform that automates the delivery of virtual machines, applications, and personalized IT services across multi-vendor and multi-cloud infrastructure. Actually, what is the ultimate goal of virtualization? So we need to create a hypervisor. On top of the hypervisor, it is required to create a virtual machines that required for our, maybe for the developers or maybe the testing team or the Scrum Masters, the DevOps engineers. So we need to provide the machines for them to reduce the capital expenditure and operational expenditure, we are getting into the virtualization environment. So by means of the hypervisor, we can able to provide that platform to them. There are two different types of hypervisors, you know very well about it. The first one is inside our vSphere suite, we are having the product that is what ESXi, type one hypervisor. On the bare metal, you can able to install a specialized OS like hypervisor, that is what ESXi. So by means of that, you can able to create your virtual machines and you can able to give the provisions to the virtual machines and the type two hypervisors. That is maybe you can use the Fusion workstation. These are the two different products. In Windows, you can use the workstation and you can go for the Mac for Fusion. So those things also you can able to create the virtual machine. What I mean to say is as an administrator, you need to create the virtual machines on it. That is what the required thing. But how you can able to automate the process of delivering the virtual machines? How it is going to be provided by means of the service catalog? That is a catalog. So you can able to create the catalog as an administrator. And you can able to create and provide that platform, that catalog to the people, those who want virtual machines. So by means of that, they can able to choose which kind of and which category of VM they want. And they can able to create their own virtual machines on any cloud environment. That is the most important feature we can able to get from the Aria Automation. Aria Automation are not focusing on the vSphere on-premises cloud itself. So even you can able to get from the architecture, you can able to implement the Aria Automation on any these different clouds, environment, platforms. It may be a vSphere for on-prem cloud, or it may be a VCF that is integrated with the, all the NSX and vSAN products. And you can able to get not only on on-prem cloud, not only on a public cloud, you can able to get from the partnered products like VMware Cloud on AWS. That is hybrid cloud. So you can able to keep expand your environment in the AWS bare metals. That is what the product called VMware Cloud on AWS. Same like that we are having Azure VMware solutions. So on that also, we can able to implement our Aria Automation. And next to that, on the public clouds, like AWS, Azure Cloud, Google Cloud platform, so Google Cloud runs. So we can able to create over that, and we can able to automate the machine deployments through this product Aria Automation, okay? And I already mentioned that inside our Aria Automation, we are having several key components that Aria Automation delivers: self-service automation, DevOps for infrastructure, and Kubernetes automation. If anyone want to create the Kubernetes native platform for the developers, those who require the microservices style of architecture. So for that, you can able to create that Kubernetes automation also. It can able to create their own workload clusters for them in that the perfect style of architecture. For example, you know very well about it, that Kubernetes require a control plane node and a worker node. The two VMs are required initially to create a development environment. If it is a production environment, so there should be a control plane node set. It should be one or three control plane node, and it should be minimum three worker nodes it requires. So by means of, you can able to automate the creation of Kubernetes environment also. That is also why another service you can able to get it from the key component. And the configuration management. How you can able to automate the configuration by means of Salt stack. You can able to use the open source Salt projects to configure the automation. And finally, you can automate the network also, network automation. The required network later things can be automated. It can able to create the tier one, tier zero gateways and the segments, because in that environment, you are able to create the virtual machines means, so that should be with the capable of creating the network for it. because automatically you are going to create the VMs. So automatically it should require that network requirements like segments, like logical routers, switches, everything. So by means of that only you can able to get the platform, the perfect software-defined data center. So that's why that also included in our Aria Automation. You can integrate, you can streamline and modernize the traditional cloud native and multi-cloud infrastructure with VMware Aria Automation. Actually, Aria Automation offers some common service catalog that I mentioned. So user can able to get that catalog. He may be an administrator, he may be a developer, he may be a business user. So he can able to request their own IT services, like he can able to request an infrastructure, he can able to request an application that he want, and he can able to request a desktop also. So those things you can able to get by means of the product with the key components that which is inside our automation. The first key component is Aria Automation Assembler, Aria Automation Consumption, and VMware Aria Automation Pipelines, and Automation Orchestrator, and finally Automation Config. Some renaming is done here after the renaming of the product. The product has been renamed from Viralize to Aria Automation. And while that renaming itself, they have renamed the internal components of automation also, Aria Automation also. Okay, we will discuss. So that can able to provide the architecture. So this is what we are having that components. Aria Automation Assembler, Aria Automation Consumption, Aria Automation Pipelines, Orchestrator, and Config. First of all, you have to know about these several components one by one. By means of that only, you can able to use and utilize the Aria Automation properly. So before getting into the Aria Automation, installation of that Aria Automation. So here I would like to explain what are the components and what are the services you can able to get from the component. First, we can get into the Aria Automation Assembler, Cloud Assembly. That is what the name of that we have used in the VRLIS. The primary purpose of Aria Automation Assembler is to create and deploy the Aria Automation templates. It is going to create some template. What is my template? The template means if I create a virtual machine, what the specifications which is in the machine? What is the specification? What are the application it can able to run? For example, in an IT firm, so it might require some of the basic applications. So those basic applications and the services should be created on the cloud resources through the Aria Automation Assembler. That is what we can mention as template. We can compare with the VMware template also. So that template was created, and that can be offered by means of the assembler. It's a cloud-based service are used to iteratively create and deploy the machines, applications, and services to multiple clouds. There are four major things are there. The first one is multiple cloud accounts it can able to manage for that. The project members from multiple cloud accounts can able to develop and deploy the templates to a production-ready state. And they can use the Kubernetes integration. It is fully integrated with the Kubernetes environment, as I mentioned. And infrastructure as code cloud templates. So I'm familiar with the code. I'm familiar with the codes like Ansible, Pulumi, or Terraform. So I would like to prefer to write a code to create my virtual machines. In the sense, you can able to create that type of codes templates also. So that will allows you to create the specifications for the virtual machines. You can write a code to create the VMs. Okay, but here in our assembler, cloud assembly, so we can create by means of YAML code. So you know very well about the YAML. It is yet another markup language, which is mainly we are using in the template as code. And you can create your own YAML format codes, and you can able to use that. That is what cloud assembler. And next to that, we are having the second component, that is what consumption. Consumption is going to aggregate the services from multiple sources, and he is going to provide, he is the one responsible for the catalog provider. So he is the one is going to provide the catalog to us. So before that, the realized product, the name of the conception is service broker. So what is the meaning of broker? You know very well about it. The broker can able to visualize what they are having. So that is what the work assigned to the conception. So he can able to visualize the catalog items like what are the realized automation templates we are having to create the virtual machines, and what are the AWS cloud formation templates to create the AWS related EC2 instances, and that realized Aria pipelines, automation pipeline. From the word pipeline itself, you can able to understand what is behind with that. Yes, that is what CICD, continuous integration and continuous delivery, that pipeline for the DevOps engineers. You can be able to use it for the code streaming. Okay, that is what the name of that next product, code stream. But now that renamed as a pipelines. So that pipeline, what are the pipeline options we are having, that can also we can able to get by means of the service catalogs. The catalog provide the list of its products, the actual meaning of the catalog, that's all, service catalog. What are the things, what are the items you can able to get from the Aria Automation? That is what you can able to get from the service catalog. So all the sources, different sources of items are organized and provided to the user by means of it. Okay, and what are the constraints there? So for the naming release, for data actions, for the approval for the products. So those things also you can able to get from the service broker, conception. A service broker, which is the name, which is used by means of realize. That is what renamed as conception. And next to the service broker, we are having code stream. That is what pipelines. Realize code stream, that is realize Aria automation pipelines. It is going to provide a stream of code processing. And so that pipeline will contain the development stage and the testing stage and the user acceptance test. And finally, that is going to be provided to the production environment. The pipeline supports deploying monolithic legacy applications in addition to Docker and Kubernetes containers running on multiple clouds. So you can use the GitHub as a repository to keep your YAML files and the templates. And for the development, you can use CodeStream Build and Bamboo Jenkins. These are the products. For testing purpose, you can use Jira and Bamboo, and you can use the acceptance testing from Jenkins, and you can able to deploy the products on the Kubernetes native platform in containerization. And that allows you to create a pipeline that runs the actions to build, deploy, test, and release your software codes. That is what I have mentioned. Those Aria Automation provide services to the DevOps engineers also, not only for the developers. So they can able to manage the entire the development process by means of this pipeline. Next to the pipeline, we are having the orchestrator. Orchestrator, what is the name? What is the meaning of the orchestration? So it is going to make automating and simplify the process of automating. So that is what the orchestrator. Orchestrator uses workflows. You can create a flow of working principle and working procedure through the workflow. Workflow is a program that contains a sequence of tasks to achieve a specific functionality by means of the multiple process. It allows you to create the VM, it allows you to do the process, it allows you to change the content, it allows you to install the inbuilt, the network related things, and it allows you to make the VM as a Kubernetes. That is a workflow with the sequence of tasks. And by means of that workflow, you can able to get the automation to do, to process, to run the workflow. We are having a separate workflow engine that comes with the orchestrator workflow engine. So how it is going to be organized, how the administrator can able to orchestrate, create the workflows and provide the flow as per the sequence. So those things you can able to get by means of the component called Aria Automation Orchestrator. It is going to ease the development and process automation by means of this platform through the workflow engine. And finally, we are having the last product called Config, Salt Stack Config. Okay. A VMware Aria Automation Config is a configuration management tool, which is going to ensure that a desired configuration state is maintained on target systems across multiple clouds. The VMware Automation Config is powered by Salt or Salt Stack. So preferably in open source, that is called Salt, but not Salt projects. But here we are calling in the name of Salt Stack, Salt Stack configuration. That is going to provide some software configuration automation component, that configuration management engine that was sponsored by VMware. What is the core concept of the Aria Automation Config? You can remote execution using the client server model. Has two different classes we are having. One is Salt Master and Salt Minion. The user, it is going to provide out the user request by means of the Salt Master as a Salt Minion. That is, Salt Master is responsible for sending the commands to the Salt Minions. And also, Salt Master can able to aggregate and display the results of commands that is received from the Salt Minions. Salt Minions is nothing but a task, and a single Salt Master can able to manage thousands of Salt Minions also, tasks also. That automation functionalities configuration can be achieved by means of that minion and master like server client model. Okay. And this is what the components. So we are calling the Aria Automation, as I mentioned at earlier itself, it is a software as a service. VMware Cloud offers a web-based software as a service. A lot of software as a services we are having. So based on the requirement, it may differ. And you can able to check whatever the software as a service by means of the management VMware, by means of a single site called cloud.vmware.com. Inside that, you can able to get multiple software as a services. Even VMC on AWS is a software as a service. Tanzu Mission Control to manage the Kubernetes environment, it's also a software as a service. Same like that, you can able to get the vRealize Aria Automation or Aria Automation by means of this cloud.vmware.com itself, which is used within the name of the previous product, vRealize Automation Cloud. So you have to enable the vRealize Automation Cloud by means of that cloud.vmware.com cloud services offered by VMware. The first time you have to sign up for the cloud services account. You have to create a cloud services account with your VMware account, my VMware account. So by means of that account, you can able to get the cloud services. If you do not have a VMware account, you can create one when you sign up also. At the sign up in process of cloud services account creation itself, you can able to create the VMware account. That different accounts are required to get to know and enable our vRealize Automation Cloud through the VMware Cloud Services organization. So by means of that only, you can able to get those components inside our Aria Automation. Yes, sir, we understand. What are the components out there? Please let me know, why I need to go to the VMware Cloud Services first? What are the benefits I can able to get it? So that is what we are going to discuss now. Benefits of VMware Cloud Services. So if you get the VMware Automation through the VMware Cloud Services, you can able to get the free trial and pay only for what you use based on your demand. And no need to patch, upgrade, or monitor your environment. That can be managed by the VMware Cloud Services itself. That is the benefit, the most important benefit of SaaS. Because he can able to manage for you. He can able to monitor for you. And he can able to do any requirement of updates or upgrades for you. So that is by means of cloud services. And you can able to get the access to new features without waiting for 6 to 12 months of release cycle. And the customer profile determines the payment methods available to you, how you can able to pay. And you can chat with VMware support, 24/7 support, or create and manage the support requests anytime. Based on the severity, it can be answered, responded, and single view across multiple clouds and data center also. So these are the benefits you can able to get. You can gain an insight across both public and private clouds to know where the workloads are deployed and how the resources are being used. So these are the benefits you will get. And here, I need to give some differentiation between the Aria Automation 8.10 and Aria Automation as a software as a service. So what is the difference between those different products and how the licensing model get differ? We will discuss one by one. Let me explain the differences between 8.10 versus SaaS. Existing VMware Aria customers can able to use the 8.10. And if it is a SaaS cloud-based environment, the new Aria customers, the requirement of sign up does not require rapid scalability, but difficult to deploy and scale on-premises capacity if it is in the SaaS. Cannot use SaaS. It is a on-prem product. You have to install the product in your environment. But SaaS, not required to product installation. That is going to be managed by means of the cloud-based service. And depend on on-premises ecosystem tools also, like IP address management, wearables, and load balancers, whatever the load balancers require. HAProxy, NSX ALB, and ALB, Amazon ALB. So a lot of load balancers you can able to get support by means of that echo, that skill set and the tools itself. So these are the differences between the 8.10 and SaaS. How it will be differ on the licensing model? Because I'm preferring to go with the suite itself means. I don't go with the global suite, cloud services suite, SaaS suite. I would like to go with the normal product the license would like to purchase. So what are the benefits you can able to give it to me? And if I plan to purchase that universal suite, global suite, cloud services suite, then what are the things I can able to get it? So that is what we are going to discuss in the next slide. Universal suite licensing model. This new subscription model, Aria Universal Suite, that is going to deploy, that offers the flexibility to deploy the Aria automation components on-premises, or you can consume the web-based SaaS service also interchangeably without the need to repurchase the licenses. You can use that both the environment. But Aria Suite only give that those four different products like Aria Suite Lifecycle, Aria Automation. The Lifecycle Manager, it is required for manage and install and manage your Aria Automation and other products also. So even though it is required to activate in our environment, it is required for that SaaS services also. We will discuss how it will be in the deployment. And you can able to get the VMware Aria operations for logs and Aria operations from that Aria Suite license itself. But additionally, if you are using Universal Suite, you can able to get all the products like same products which is in the suite, and also the SaaS related products, Operation SaaS and Operations for Log SaaS and Automation SaaS, Skyline Advisor, you can able to get that license also, license support. Skyline support also you can able to get from the SaaS. And you can able to get some of the additions while getting into the subscription model, the pricing, and you can able to compare with the help of vmware.com/products/aria-universal-site-suite.html. Okay, you can able to get what are the things you can able to avail from the different editions of licenses, standard, enterprise, like that. And this is what the overview of our Aria Automation. Let me get into the architecture, Aria Automation architecture, how the architecture will be. Three things are involved here for deployment. Three products are involved here. One is, from the lifecycle manager, it is going to start our process. You can able to get start by means of the lifecycle manager. And through the lifecycle manager, you have to install the workspace, VMware Identity Manager plus Aria Automation. So that VMware Identity Manager was replaced by our workspace. how the workspace can able to act as identity manager, identity service while deploying our Aria Automation. So whenever you want to deploy the product Aria Automation, you have to be with the license lifecycle manager, Aria lifecycle manager, and it should be with the VMware identity manager and Aria Automation. Even in that, we are having two different types of deployments. You can able to deploy Aria Automation in two different categories. One is standard, another one is clustered. In our standard deployment, we are going to deploy, as I said, it is going to deploy the workspace, only one workspace, one access, and only one Aria Automation appliance. There is an appliance. Yes, we know that there is appliance is required to manage the product, like our vCenter server, our NSX manager. If you want to get that NSX, so you have to be with that NSX manager and you have to be connected with the compute manager of vCenter server. Same like that, there is appliance. That appliance should be required to install in our environment, in our STDC. The standard deployments are primarily going to use it for the small environments because it is having only one workspace, one access, and the Aria Automation appliance. It will not going to use any cluster-like applications. You can able to manage, install, config everything by means of the lifecycle manager, Aria Suite Lifecycle. But same like that, we are having the cluster deployment architecture. So it can able to provide that cluster deployment, cluster of workspace one access, and cluster of appliances for balance your demand. And to avoid the single point of failure, you can able to that 100% of availability without any downtime, you can able to get those cluster deployments also. For large concerns, large performance concerns, they can use that clustered deployment architecture. We have to deploy with the load balancer. It is required because the request can able to balance by means of that load balancer. Okay. So this is what the thing. So what is that Aria Lifecycle Suite? That Suite Lifecycle provides a solution to deploy, upgrade, configure, and manage some Aria Suite products. Automation, Workspace ONE, Aria Operations, Operations for Logs and Networks. Everything can be managed by means of the single Aria Automation Lifecycle. And that can be getting into it by means of our Workspace ONE Access. It is IDS as a service, identity as a service. That is what Workspace ONE Access. So that replaces our VMware Identity Manager. It provides multi-factor authentication and conditional access and single sign-on to our SaaS. So you can able to install that Workspace ONE Access also from our Aria Suite Lifecycle. And finally, we can get our appliance, automation appliance. That is going to install a Photon OS. Inside that, it is going to create a Kubernetes native platform because our functionalities and the process which is required to implement our Aria Automation can be run by means of the Kubernetes pods itself. What is a pod? Pod is the smallest deployable object in our Kubernetes. So using that, you can able to get the services. Rapid MQ is required. That is also going to be installed inside our appliance to run as a pod also. It is an industry standard message bus used in the Aria Automation tool. And the PostgreSQL, that PostgreSQL runs as a pod also. That is going to provide a persistent volume rather than the ephemeral disk. We need to keep record the details, the content which is stored. So that is what that can be stored by means of the persistent volumes provided by the any disk space. So it is going to keep our PostgreSQL in it. Why we use the Kubernetes? What is the role of Kubernetes here? Because that the Kubernetes are required to run the pods. If you want to run the pods, if you want to run the process as a pod, in the sense, some of the things are required. The Docker should be installed. The Kubernetes cluster should be required. And Helm should be required to manage the registry in our environment. So by means of that only, you can able to run your services as a pod. It is easy to run. And that pod can be orchestrated by means of the Kubernetes easily. For example, if any pod get down, what will happen? If you are using Kubernetes, then the Kubernetes also an orchestration tool that is going to reschedule and restart the pod automatically. You do not require to manage that. So that's why the Aria appliance require a Kubernetes native platform that is going to place the services inside the pod like this. We are having PostgreSQL pod. We are having VCO pod to implement our microservices. So VCO control center, server, and polycod runner. So those things are going to run inside our environment. Control center, control architecture, orchestrator. So there is a namespace. What is the namespace? It's a building construct to provide the resource limits and the boundary for that. So for that reason, we can able to use the namespaces. Actually, namespace divide our Kubernetes cluster resources between multiple users, tenants, multiple tenancy you can able to get by means of that namespaces itself. So that's why they are using the default namespace called Prelude. So you have to get to so that Prelude is the most important one while troubleshooting your automation tool. It is required for managing the pods. You have to get into that context. That is what Prelude. Okay. So these are the things we require to know about the installation. How to install VMware Aria Automation Tool. That is what we are going to discuss from the next context. Actually, there is an installer. Easy installer we are having. Aria Easy Installer. Easy Installer. That helps you to install the lifecycle suite first. And from there, you can able to install the Workspace ONE and Aria Automation. Please do not require to implement by means of anything because this is the flow. You have to start from the Easy Installer and you have to install the suite lifecycle. And you can install the Workspace ONE from that. And you can install an appliance for Aria Automation from there. So that is an order. That order is described here. Installing each component requires some time and effort. That Easy Installer simplifies the installation process through a single installation wizard. By means of that only, you can able to implement. First, for that, you have to download that ISO file. Easy Installer ISO file, and you can mount and run the executable file. And from there, you can able to deploy and configure the suite lifecycle first. And by means of that, you can able to install the Workspace ONE access, and that helps you to install our Aria Automation, that is lifecycle suite. So all they are considered as appliance. You can imagine we are requiring to install three different appliances to run Aria Automation. Those who are having idea about the previous, that 6. vSphere, 6. Version earlier, 6.7 version earlier. To implement our vCenter server, we require to install PSE appliance and we have to install the vCenter server. Now it has changed to single application, single appliance. Same like that, to install Aria Automation, it is required to install three different appliances. This is the flow. This is the step. You have to implement your, you have to download the AC installer and you can mount the ISO and then start the first initialization, first element, suite lifecycle. Through this suite lifecycle, you can install Workspace and Aria Automation. Now the Aria Automation are required to configure and you can use the services which is running inside by means of the different components. Service broker, cloud assembly, consumption, code stream, those things. Okay. So that is, we require to install three different products, three different appliances. The Easy Installer is going to install. If I talk in the version 8.10, just assume. So you are going to install VMware 8. Aria Automation 8.10. So you have to install 3.3.4 for Aria Workspace ONE Access Appliance and 8.10.0.6 for Aria Suite Lifecycle Manager. Okay. And there is an installer. So this is the requirement, resource requirement. 2 CPU, 6 GB of RAM, and at least 78 GB of disk. And you can able to expand the size also. But minimum requirement is that. That is what the requirement. and 8 CPU, 16 GB of RAM memory, and 100 GB of disk, persistent volume disk, and 12, 42, and 246 GB of disk for Aria Automation appliance required. Then we can start the process. The first step is, it is required to install, download, and install the, use the installer by means of mounting. By means of that, you can able to start the installation. You can able to start, get the installer. You can able to mount in whatever your operating system, underlying operating system. It may be a Linux, it may be a Mac, it may be a Windows, you can able to implement. So from that installer, you can able to get two steps, actually two different process. One is you can start the installation, or else if you are having the previous versions of Aria, that is 8.3, 8.5 like that, you can able to migrate to the 8 or 10. That is also allowed. Okay, installation and migration from earlier versions to the current instance, and easy installer sections. So we are having the installer sections to provide some common configurations and application specific configurations. The common configurations like so end user license agreement and appliance where we are going to deploy it. That is which vCenter server we are going to deploy it. What is the IP address with the administrator credentials and location, which data center and folder, and what is the compute source, vSphere cluster, and storage, which data store we are going to deploy, and network, password, the network details like configuring the management cluster, network settings, DHCP, network subnet, gateway, domain name, NTP servers, those things. And next to that, the lifecycle manager configuration, identity manager, that is what workspace, and Aria automation, that is what VRealize automation configuration, that is mentioned in the name of VRealize. So you have to provide these details like lifecycle configuration. For that lifecycle configuration, what is the virtual appliance, virtual machine appliance for the suite lifecycle, and what is the IP address, and which host it is going to deploy, what is the host name, and which some of the details for the vCenter server. So what is the data center name? What is the vCenter server name? And the disk size in GB. But the minimum requirement is 78 GB. You can keep 100 GB also. That means after 78, you can able to add that GB of size. Next to the Aria suite lifecycle, you can install, you can provide the configuration details for the workspace one access. That define the virtual machine name and what is the IP address of the appliance and the host name, like so you can able to compare, say iPhone vCenter server appliance iPhone 01.vclass.local. So same like that, you can able to provide the configuration details like this. So VIDM, which VMware identity manager and IP, and VMware identity manager iPhone 01.vclass.local, and the default configuration admin and that email that is required to configure, to get into the workspace. Okay. Next to that, we can provide Aria Automation configuration, like the basic requirements to install the Aria Automation. What is the VRA environment and license key for that Aria Automation and virtual machine name and same IP address, host name, and internal pods and services. And what is the cluster IP CADR, pod IP CADR, and service IP CADR. All the things you have to provide by means of that deployment itself. So finally, you can install, complete that install, and you can able to monitor the installation steps through the easy installer itself. How the installation progresses. If you get any issues, you can able to get the details by means of it. That is, the progress of installation can be monitored by means of the Aria easy installer. And you can, if you get any failures, if you get any problems while installing that Aria Automation products, you can able to get where we are getting the problem issue and which place it get and which, what is the reason for the failure. So those details you can able to monitor by means of that easy installer itself. Okay. And then you can able to get the environment. Environment is a logical entity that is going to use and enable the Aria Automation products, different products. you want. It can able to create some different environments like global environment and Aria automation environment. That global environment are deploying and managing the workspace one access. So that can be managed by means of the quick start, all the services. So you can able to get in the name cloud assembly. These are the names I have mentioned to you while explaining the concepts that our key components like our consumption, cloud as our assembler, that the assembler is also called as cloud assembly, pipelines, core stream, and orchestration, salt stack config. These are the actual names which is used in the realize. So you can able to get that actual name in our console itself, Aria Automation console itself. Okay. So hereby you can able to configure the things. You can able to configure the required things. You can able to add or select the vCenter server account with the NSX manager instance. And you can able to add an integration to the STDC manager already there. So these steps you can able to follow by means of that quick start itself. This is what installation process. And you can also migrate our Aria automation from 7.x to 8.x from that easy installer itself. So migrating the Aria automation, you can use one of the following methods. You can create a Aria automation 8.x system. Do not migrate the components. Migrate a recent version of Aria 7.4 or later directly to Aria Automation 8.x and update the earlier versions of 7.x to Aria Automation 7.6 and migrate them to the 8.10. It is easy to migrate it. The several types of realize automation 7.x system objects are transformed with many new features when they migrate to Aria Automation 8.x. The easy installer can able to provide that support for migration also. So this is the end of our session. So hereby, I would like to summarize what we have discussed in this content. So we have started our discussion from what is the overview, what are the components we can able to get our Aria automation, and how it is going to be implemented, and by means of those components, that is what we have discussed. And also the thing which is having for our services, the component, what are the services you can able to get from that. And finally, we discussed that Aria cloud or services in that context and how that services can able to implement it by means of cloud services, VMware cloud services organization. And next to that, what are the categories of deployment, standard deployment, and cluster deployment, where it is going to be deployed, and in which category it is going to require to deploy, what are the prerequisites, what is the workflow of the deployment, that is what we discussed. After that, we are getting into the process of installation from our easy installer, how that easy installer can be mounted, and how you can able to install the product. That is also we have discussed. Okay, so this is the end of the session. I would like to answer the queries in the chat. What is the future scope of for Aria automation? Future scope in the sense, Prasad, actually, most of the things are automated now. Even the normal environment, normal scope applications are requiring the automation standards, automation features. So that Aria automation will play a perfect automation in our all the virtualization environment. And next to that, next to the question, there is a question called where exactly this Aria automation is applied and which fields do you wish to recommend to use and why? And the Aria automation is required to manage whatever the cloud environment. You do not require to specifically manage it. If you are an AWS administrator, for example, you can take it out. So over there, if you want to automate the services which is used in the AWS, like creation of S3, creation of EC2, over there, you can able to make by means of that. Okay, so that is what. And inside that Aria automation, all the components are required. You can't able to neglect anything. The last one. So some of the things are required more programming related features like that salt stack configurations. So you can, before going for that, you can able to create a service catalog. you can keep the templates, and by means of that, you can be able to implement the automation. Okay, so that is what we are having. And next to that, next, the Prasad asked a valuable question. Thank you, Lion King, and I would like to go to the question from Prasad. Ansible and Terraform. Yes, even in the start itself, I have mentioned that two different words. Definitely, it is required, but it will not replace the Aria Automation. That will help you to get more with the Aria Automation. You can use infrastructure code also to make the automation instead of YAML. If you are familiar with Ansible, if you are familiar with Terraform, you can implement the automation by means of it inside our Aria templates also. You can able to create the workflows, you can able to create the templates in your that Ansible and Terraform. So definitely Ansible and Terraform will not replace Aria Automation, will improve the capabilities of Aria Automation if you are having that Ansible and Terraform knowledge. Okay, and yes, this is the end of the questions. Yes, thank you so much, Terebi. And thanks to one and all who attend the session, and thanks to Rupali to give this opportunity. And I would like to thank everyone who is behind with this for the opportunity given for this webinar. Thank you. Thanks to all. Thank you. Thanks to all. Happy weekend.